there's virtually no other infrastructure player in the market except us. So there's definitely a need to build infrastructure and then sort of from infrastructure expand or sort of extend the application layer, probably a few years from now. But it definitely starts with infrastructure, and we were the only ones who are keen to get in the space and sort of had enough funding and I guess will and skill to go into that space. And we're filling a real need and a real gap. And it's been an interesting time for us since mid-2015 when we launched. Yeah.
And I guess from that perspective, yes, as well. So when you're building infrastructure from your context, what kind of how do you choose who is kind of the right players, which you work with, which you don't? What is the kind of criteria that you look for while building a scale of those
things? Sure. I think there is obviously different partnerships that you want to build depending on the platform that you're building and sort of the consumer base that you're that you're serving. So there are different partnerships that you want to build locally. So when you're talking about banks, and different local players, and there are other partnerships that you want to build with the Bitcoin space, specifically around, well, in our case, was liquidity, I would say. From a technology perspective, we built our own technology stack internally, so we haven't relied on sort of third-party software, with the exception of our wallets with BitGo, which we think that was very important for us to kind of get the level of security that we needed when we first started. So from a technology perspective, there hasn't been sort of a lot of different partners that we've worked with, but I think it was specifically around liquidity in the early days when we started our platform. In our market, there are no miners, big merchants, or some of the different sort of ecosystem players that you find in the US and Europe and China. I would say, the sort of the only dominant or main player in cryptocurrencies in our space. So we had to bootstrap a lot of things on our own and then sort of rely on external partnerships. DCG was specifically very helpful with that. So we partnered up with Genesis Group, Michael Morrow, and then we partnered with other larger exchanges to sort of have credit lines and make sure that we channel in liquidity locally. Luckily, at this point, obviously, with the adoption increasing, we got to a point where we have sort of like a nice balance of buys and sells, so we have enough kind of liquidity locally to keep growing. And that was sort of the point that we really needed to get to, that we're able to build exchange liquidity or have enough liquidity locally that we're able to just launch our own exchange without relying on liquidity externally. But obviously to get there, you really need to sort of build the right partnerships, whether it is from a liquidity standpoint or banking or some security to get to that level.
Yeah.